I'll say that Christian Zionism in general is a very colonial way of reading the Bible and also a very white supremacist type of viewing of the Bible.
They see in it an image of God who is a tribal God who favors one nation over everyone else.
When I was in seminary, I read a book that changed my life, and it was called The Religion of White Supremacy in the United States by Eric Weed. We were told to read it and give a short reflection on how it impacted our relationship to the Christian faith. For context, this was written in March 2020 when I was really in the heart of my process of deconstruction, and just days before we went into lockdown for COVID, after which we physically couldn't go into church anymore. That book and this reflection was a big moment of reckoning in my spiritual journey. In his book, The Religion of White Supremacy in the United States, Eric Weed uses the phrase the epistemology of whiteness often. As epistemology in his book means the process of knowledge consumption and creation, he shares that the epistemology of whiteness signifies the ways in which whiteness is constructed and maintains itself through dissemination. White supremacy in America uses Christianity as a foundational framework for its violent, hierarchical, and colonialist practices. Christianity becomes weaponized, violence justified using scripture, a religion that belongs to a god of white supremacy, its leader, a white man named Jesus Christ, who provided the Great Commission of colonization. In the Christian Bible, Mark 16, verses 15 through 16 reads, "And Jesus said unto them, Go ye into the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believes and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believes not will be damned. And they, the other, were damned. They were damned to lynching, separation from their lands and children, damned to murder, rape, and mutilation. They were damned to the destruction of their homes and businesses, to all manner of evil in service of white supremacy. All those who are identified as heathens or barbaric would learn to fear God." The religion of white supremacy and Christianity in the American context are in many ways indistinguishable. Weed notes that the religion of white supremacy is forever framed by its Genesis myth. He points to the Genesis chapter 1 verses 26 scripture in the Christian Bible, which calls for humankind to have dominion over the cattle and over the wild animals of the earth. Non-white people were identified under this scripture as objects, property. They became heathens and barbarians, wild animals and cattle to have dominion over. And for the religion of white supremacy, this was God's will. Weed points to historical events as evidence of the religion of white supremacy's dissemination, or spread, as in a disease. The Pequot War of 1636 and the Indian Removal Act of 1830 are examples of events in which heathens were forcibly removed from lands that they owned with violence and brutality. The Marion lynching and the Tulsa race riots serve as examples of ritual sacrifice to the god of white supremacy and holy war waged against the black body. The god of white supremacy also gives his followers the divine right to preserve sacred space for white bodies by any means necessary, the process that includes the purification of the land from non-believers of this god. With regards to how I think and feel about Christianity, I am in a very weird space. I grew up in an apostolic evangelical church that was predominantly black, but in many ways participated in the religion of white supremacy. And I didn't become aware of many of these things until I came to seminary. We spoke negatively about religious traditions that we didn't understand. We asserted the supremacy of our God over other gods. Our church was laden with images of the white Christ on the windows and on the church fans. The list goes on. My foundation has been rocked in light of new information, and I am in the process of reconstructing my spiritual beliefs. It has been challenging, and I am growing weary, but I must do the work for my sanity and survival. My grandmother's Christianity saved my life. It was through a devotion to Christ that she took my brother and I in to raise us after she had raised six children of her own. "I changed my life for you," she once told me. Her sacrifice in her life is a thread that keeps me tied to the Christian heritage, but for so many reasons I am ashamed and hesitant to say that I am a Christian today. Until I do more wrestling with this heritage, I have been choosing to identify myself as a believer, and in this season, the only thing I know to believe in is love. Feel free to leave your thoughts in the comments, and as always, like and follow for more content.
There's another chapter in this story, and the chapter of the story is Europe didn't want the Jews, North America didn't want the Jews, Australia didn't want the Jews, and the quote-unquote Jewish problem gets quote-unquote solved by spatially displacing it onto Palestine, and the mantle of whiteness gets passed to the Jews, and it's their turn. And this is somehow imagined as reparations, except it's replication. So we are in this historical loop. But this is why, you know, we have to admit that Israel is founded in trauma. Like, it is both a replica of settler colonialism and also a new iteration of it, because it's being cast as reparations for genocide. This is a new twist. And if we can't sort of look at that complexity and understand how central it is to Israel's own narrative of itself, I'm not sure we get out of the loop.